Welcome back to KTLA 5 Live. We often talk about coffee, but there's a green phase taking over not just Southern California, but all over the world. It's matcha. And we have Max Fortgang with MatchaBar here to talk about it. If you see green on a plate, a lot of people immediately think healthy.
Yes.
What is matcha?
So matcha comes from the green tea plant, like all the other green tea you've ever had. But they actually harvest it a bit differently and work, and actually then go and pick the leaves very specifically to make the matcha that we know and love and celebrate as being like super healthy for you. So basically they're shade growing the green tea plant for about 3 months before harvest, paying very special attention to how, like, the exact distance between the tarping and the leaves and the airflow and every little thing, very meticulous. And then they're actually taking the leaves that were shade grown and stone grinding them into what we know as matcha. The reason they shade grow it is because the plants are restricted from how much sunlight they're getting and work really hard to stay alive. That builds up the chlorophyll content where all the nutrients that we know and love that are associated with matcha come from. So that's, you know, antioxidants, elevated caffeine levels, and elevated L-theanine, which is actually a natural occurring amino acid in all green tea, but in heightened levels in matcha actually helps you get that balanced energy that people associate with matcha.
So you can't just take green tea leaves and grind them up.
No, you cannot. And that's actually a common misconception. Besides those shade grown leaves, all the other leaves in the plants are actually used, and they can be stone ground, but that is what kind of makes up culinary grade matcha, which is used for ice cream, baked goods, and, like, you know, matcha Kit Kats. All the things that are flavored with matcha are usually like a much lower grade tea that is great tasting, but doesn't have all of those nutrients that are associated with matcha.
All right, so then I have some breaking news, which is I thought I could just ground up the leaves and that was it, and I had a new career. So it looks like I'm gonna have to stay here because that plan is now ruined.
No.
But I have a question. How does someone get so, how do you know so much about that? Where did this come from? Did you just love, you said chlorophyll, that reminded me of like science class when I was in seventh grade.
Where did
all this come from?
So this is a tradition that has been going on in Japan for thousands of years. The monks and the samurai actually pioneered it. There's a lot of debate whether it was actually invented in China or Japan, and I'm going to stay out of that one for good reason.
It was invented in Williamsburg.
Yeah, no. And I also never say that because that would be very offensive to a lot of people. But we actually just started... We were born and raised in New York. Me and my brother, my co-founder and my business partner, and, you know, one of my best friends in life.
Big brother or little brother?
Little brother.
Oh, okay. So he had no choice. You made him do it.
yeah. Definitely pulled him along on this one. You know, we were deep in the throes of the caffeine game. You know, growing up in the city, the land of cafes and energy drinks. Especially when we were growing up, there were, you know, Red Bull was such a big thing, Gives You Wings campaign had taken off, and we found ourselves very, very early, maybe too early, on this caffeine cycle and overconsumption. So at about, I think he was about maybe 21, I was 23, we're 2 years apart, we started looking for alternatives, being like, we're young guys, but we feel totally ravaged by this caffeine overconsumption. Like, we're waking up tired, but we're also like 23. Mm-hmm. You know, like, when are we gonna have more energy naturally? Probably never. Let's like try to do some lifestyle work and, you know, start thinking more consciously about what we're putting in our bodies, especially on like an everyday level.
Right.
So we started looking into tea, you know, going to all the many like tea houses in New York and just trying different stuff, asking people that knew much better than us, you know, what's a tea that can give you an extra kick energy wise? And finally we found matcha, and our lives really actually, I know it sounds cliche, but it totally changed our lives and our balance. And you know, the sort of like work, you know, how, what we were using to hustle, you know, totally radically changed. And we, you know, in, as a result, we found like we were actually finally, the morning cup that we were getting was finally measuring up to this fantasy that we had built up in our heads as like, oh, you drink a coffee and then everything is like great from there. We weren't really experiencing that. And especially not with, with the Red Bull craze and all that. We finally, when we found matcha, we found like, oh, this is something that we can really get behind in a healthy way and power our day with confidently.
What is the difference when people want the caffeine kick? This is stronger than regular green tea.
Yeah.
By how much? Like, how much extra caffeine am I getting?
Yeah, so in a regular cup of green tea, you'd get like 20 to 30, maybe 35 milligrams in a really strong cup. Matcha sits about 70 to 80.
Okay.
Espresso sits at about 110 all the way up to 120 sometimes. And a cold brew could be more than that. Mm-hmm. So if you can imagine, you know, the matcha's like, you know, less but comparable. Mm-hmm. It can get you there. And the other thing about matcha is that because it's in the powdered form and like the composition of the leaf is still intact, it actually takes a longer time to break down in your bloodstream. So the extension of that caffeine is sort of like, you feel it sort of being released over a longer period of time.
It's like a time release tablet.
Exactly. Okay. But all natural.
So what do we have in front of us? Because now that you're talking about it, I want to drink it.
Yeah. How soon can I cut into going into this?
Cut in right away.
So what does Natalie have here?
Yeah. Natalie has what we call a Sun Potion latte because of our partners at Sun Potion that make an amazing ashwagandha powder. It's super grounding, stress relieving, and then we do the house-made milk that we have in the store, and then the bee pollen on top as a garnish.
What is ashwagandha powder?
Ashwagandha is a mushroom. Okay. And then it's a powdered mushroom. It really gives it like a toasty flavor. A lot of people balk, we're using mushrooms in a drink, at a tea drink.
Right.
But when you taste it, you'll be like, oh, this is very, very,
who are these
very
people?
Mellow.
Who are these people balking at mushrooms in a drink? Come on.
Yeah, I don't know. It's crazy.
Where are you guys growing your tea leaves?
It all comes from Kagoshima in Japan, which is like the southern tip of Japan. There's a active volcano right there called Mount Sakurajima. And that gives it like amazing volcanic soil. It's one of the most fertile places in Japan to grow.
Two questions. So is that what sets you apart, MatchaBar, from everybody else? Second question, what am I drinking?
So you're drinking a rose latte.
Okay.
And that's a house-made rose syrup, almond milk, and matcha with rose petals on top and a little rose water for aroma.
Presentation, I have to say, is amazing.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
Okay,
it's
so
really pretty.
MatchaBar, is that
yes.
where you grow your leaves or get your leaves from? Is that what makes you different?
That's one of the reasons that makes us different. I think we have an amazing family farm that's been doing it for generations upon generations. The farm we partner with, actually, the owner of the farm has been in the tea industry for a very long time. He's one of 14 people that have passed what they call a 10th grade chashi exam.
Oh my gosh.
Which means he's a master tea blender,
right.
basically.
Amazing.
Instead of, you know, to keep from getting too technical. But he blends the tea with me, and we get to do, you know, actually work on tea blends together, which is like such an honor.
Do you just geek out with this guy?
Are you kidding? Yeah, that's like my entire life is geeking out on matcha.
Tea. So what does Scott have? Because that's kind of an American twist with matcha.
Yeah, so Scott's drinking what we're calling a wild palmer. It's like new to the menu this season for the summer. And it's going to continue on the fall menu as well because it's been so popular. It's actually a collab that I did with my friend Chloe, who owns a company called Wildflower Boom. She is responsible for a lot of the garnishes that we're working with. And
like
does the cornflower.
Is that for people who I've been told to use it in smoothies, bowls, whatever, for allergies.
Mm-hmm.
So is that what Natalie has on hers?
Yeah, that's bee pollen. And so just to get back to the wild palmer,
sure.
That's a half and half, but instead of doing it with black tea, we do it with like a licorice, dandelion lemonade.
Ooh, Scott. That?
You guys know that I love dandelion and licorice mixes, and plus, I like the name because it reminds me of an Arnold Palmer, which is, I think, the mix. I get it 100%.
You look like a licorice guy.
I feel like a licorice guy, which is the most important part. But we obviously are asking all of the kind of formulaic, tell us about matcha, which I assume most people, when they meet you and you tell them what you do, they probably have all of these questions. If you could talk about something other than the matcha, what is another topic? If someone comes in and sees you and they say, I want to talk about matcha, and you're like, okay, but just for like 1 minute, not matcha. What else do you like to talk about?
You, Max, the person.
Me as a person?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, so many things, especially complaining about my Knicks these days.
Oh, see, there we go. Yeah. There's the end. So we
put
go
basketball
there, we see
in
Max.
There. Scott is
we
there.
Talk about the Knicks. What are you guys doing, by the way?
Praying, commiserating with each other, hanging out under bridges.
You can put matcha with Max and take him out of the city, but he's still gonna be mad about the Knicks.
Yes.
Yeah, no, I mean, that's 100%. I also am like a little upset that I lived here for 14 months building out the Silver Lake store, but didn't overlap with LeBron.
That's I have one last question for you. Mm. If somebody's still scared to drink something that's this green, yes. what do you think you could say to get somebody to try matcha? What does it taste like?
Yeah, so I think that, you know, matcha, as I was sort of saying, there's a like wine or like, you know, a lot of things, there's a huge range that you can get that falls under the headline of matcha. I think one of the best things about us is the way we blend the tea to make it actually incredibly smooth. Like you guys, I made sort of specialty signature drinks that we do in the store for you. But just drinking matcha straight up, it's almost smoother than a lot of black or green teas.
Awesome. Congratulations. What a great company. If you guys want to go to Matcha Bar, it's in Silver Lake, or you could just go to your local Whole Foods and get your hustle on.
Yeah. I'm loving it, Max. Thanks so much.
Amazing. Thank you, guys.
And we're going to continue to sip on this as we go to break here on KTLA 5 Live.